Guys, it is almost February. Can you believe it? It's insane. It feels like we just hit 2024, but I'm really excited to see what we're gonna be reading in February. So today we're gonna randomly choose my February TBR with a random number generator. I'm very excited for this. I don't think we've ever done this before. The last time we always used like a TBR jar and we would put the numbers in, which was fun, but I think that this will be really fun too. Also, do you notice anything different? Yes, I cut my hair. I've had my braids in for almost 3 months and I've just been super lazy. So instead of taking them out, I just cut the ends and put a bow in it. We're just gonna keep rocking this until the wheels fall off, okay? I do not feel like spending the entire day taking out my hair. So this is the situation for today. What y'all think? I think it's cute too. All right, let's go.
But before we start, I would love to thank today's sponsor, BetterHelp. BetterHelp is an online therapy service that allows you to speak with a licensed therapist virtually. Not only will the therapist listen to you and hear you out, but they'll also provide you with unbiased advice. I personally love the versatility of BetterHelp because not only do you talk to them virtually, but you get to decide how you talk to them. So that can be through messaging, video call, or just a phone call. You get to decide what's best for you. Plus, with their network of over 30,000 licensed therapists, you're sure to find someone that resonates with you. All you have to do to get started is use the link in my description box. It's betterhelp.com/Kalila, and this will allow you to get 10% off your first month of therapy. Once you click the link, it's super straightforward. All you have to do is answer a quick questionnaire, and you're usually matched with a licensed therapist, in most cases, in less than 48 hours, which is really incredible. And once you're connected with a therapist, if you feel like they're not necessarily a match for you, there's no extra fees. All you have to do is change your therapist for the next session and see if they're a better match for you. So again, if you think that this is a resource that can benefit you, which I think it will, all you have to do is use my link in the description box. Again, that's betterhelp.com/Kalila. This gives you 10% off your first month of therapy. And thank you again to BetterHelp for sponsoring this portion of the video.
Now, I'm not done with our January TBR yet, but so far they've been okay. I've read a lot of really strange books. Like, so far I just finished Earthlings and that was a wild ride. I'm not even gonna lie. I genuinely don't even know how to rate that book. At first, it was disturbing, but I thought it was really good. And a lot of January's books have been like that, so I'm hoping that in February we get a lot of 5-star reads. Needless to say, I'm really counting on this number generator today because I need something that's gonna get me hooked. I need something that's gonna be my next, like, best book of the year. I know it's only February and that's really high hopes, but I really wanna get lost in a book this month. So hopefully we can do that today. Before we get started though, I think we should turn over all the books that I've already read so that when we're picking them, we don't have to worry about picking duplicates. I'm trying to get smarter about these book challenges. I didn't realize there were so many books that I haven't read. On some rows, I've read so many of the books, but on a lot of them, I haven't read any, which is insane. I'm not gonna lie, I really hope we get a lot of literary fiction this month because that's what I've been in the mood to read. And we have so many good options. I'm realizing that's my favorite genre. What's your favorite genre? Let me know in the comments below. Ooh, this was so good. I really need to read Daisy Jones and the Six. I read Girl, I read this too. Wow, this looks pretty cool. I didn't realize I read a lot of these books. I'm really proud of myself. I feel like we could definitely read more, but it's not as bad as I thought it would be. I'm excited. All right, so I have the random number generator. All you have to do is shake it for it to pick a random number. I have about 177 books, but we did turn around all the books that I have read yet. So then when I count, I'm not gonna count the books that I've read. So I think I'm just gonna put like 150 in here. We'll say the maximum number is 150. And now we randomize. I'm excited. Okay, I'm gonna shake it and I'm gonna close my eyes and try to guess. Ready? Go. Chow, I closed it. Okay. Ready? Go. I'm gonna say it says 40.
Nope.
21. Okay, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 20, 21. This is the first book of February. I've never read a book by Octavia Butler, but I've heard this was really, really good. I'm excited. I think this is gonna be good. All right, on to number two. Ready? All right, I'm gonna say it says 13. Wow, I'm terrible at this. 89. 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29.
1 hour later.
89! Ah! I wanted to read this for so long. 89 is Babel. We are reading Babel in February. Are you excited? I'm excited. I've heard this was so good, and secretly, I wanted another R of Kuang book because in January I read Yellowface, and man, I'm not gonna get my review now, but man, I got a lot to say about that book. So these are our first two books for February. On to number three, let's see. Can you guess what it says? I'm gonna give you a second to guess. Are you ready? I bet you're wrong, but are you ready? 114. So that was 89, 93, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. You will not believe what number 14 is. Are you ready? We have so many good picks. I wanted to read this forever. All right, the next one is 18. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. President Barack Obama himself. In Black History Month, you love to see it. All right, we're on our last one. Randomize. 2. Wow. 2 is a Christmas book. I don't really want to read a Christmas book. I haven't cheated all day today. Give me this one. Give me this one. Thank you. Or you know what I can do? Instead of cheating, I can count from this way. How about that? Or I can count from here. Or I can count from here. We got so many options. Okay, let's see. All right, 2 from here is What Moves the Dead. 2 from this way is The Rabbit Hutch. 2 from up here is If We Were Liars. All right, and I think let's try this side over here too. Hold on. 2 from up here. Ah! 2 from up here is Fahrenheit 451. So we have a lot of fantastic options for the last one. Oh my God, this is gonna be really tough. All right, final round. Let's see what all of them are about. Now this one I do know. Everyone and their mom has told me how good this book is, how I need to read it, and I have a special edition, so it's so cute. This is about 7 kids who are involved in some type of murder, and one of them goes to jail for a really long time, and apparently he may or may not have done it. So this could be really good. Next up is The Rabbit Hutch. Now, The Rabbit Hutch has a really good synopsis on the back. The thing that got me was this end part. It says, set over one sweltering week in July and culminating in a bizarre act of violence that finally changes everything. The Rabbit Hutch is a stunning snapshot of contemporary America, a love poem to anyone who has ever felt trapped, left behind, or forgotten, and yearned to connect to be free. This sounds good. I don't know. This might be If We Were Villains, but let's read the rest. Then the next one is What Moves the Dead. Now I know that this is written off of one of Edgar Allan Poe's poems, and it's like a new modern take on it, so this could be really good as well. And last but not least, of course, is the classic Fahrenheit 451. This is like a dystopian world, so we have a lot of great options here. I don't know. I know that this is gonna be good, but this ending, this back really caught my attention. Plus, I still haven't finished 1984, and I kinda wanna read that before I read this. This sounds good, but I think I should read that a little bit later. So ultimately, I think it's between these two. The Rabbit Hutch and What Moves the Dead. I don't know. What do you think? A lot of these books that we have for February are kind of thick, so we might need a short book. Because President Obama, he's talking about a lot here. Babel is huge. Beartown is kind of thick too. Okay, I think I want to read The Rabbit Hutch. I knew you probably know I was going to pick that one, but I want to read this. Wow, we have all of our February reads. This is insane. It's such a crazy mashup. We have Beartown by Frederick Backman. This I know is incredible. Everyone talks about it. Plus, this will be my first book by Frederick Backman, so I'm excited about that. Then there's Babel. This book I've been wanting to read for so long. I just know this girl is my kind of author. She might even be one of my favorite authors at this point. So I want to see if this book solidifies her place for me. After that, we have an Octavia Butler book. This will be my first book by her as well. I've heard wonderful things about her writing, especially this book. Didn't she also write The Parable of the Sower? She did! Wow! I gotta read that too. Then, of course, we have A Promised Land by President Barack Obama himself. I read all of Michelle Obama's books, but I haven't read any of his books yet, so I'm excited to see how he writes compared to Michelle. This is gonna be good. They're like my idols. I look up to them so much. I think they carry themselves so well. I think they're so intelligent, so wise, so kind and understanding. So I'm really hoping his book lives up to his persona that I have for him. And last but not least, of course, we have The Rabbit Hutch. This sounds so, so good. I just love literary fiction. I love books that make you look at humanity a little bit different or a little more empathetically. So this just sounds like it's right up my alley. And it's my first book by Tess Gunty. So we'll see if we like her. All right, guys, that was a lot. I am so excited for February now. I definitely feel like it's gonna be better than my January reads, but we don't know yet. We're not done January yet, so I'm not counting it out. Regardless, thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye.